Welcome to ICE. My name is Salvador Alaniz. I'm one of the co-founders of the Institute for Creative Exchange. I am very thrilled to have this week Fernando Montiel Clint. Fernando is an extraordinary photographer. He's, you will see his work is really trendy, exciting, very attractive work. His work is part of collections all over the world, and last series Dystopia has been receiving extraordinary reviews with very high critical comments, and so we are very honored to have Fernando. We reach Fernando Montiel at his studio in Mexico City. Fernando, thank you for accepting the invitation to talk, and we are super excited to have you as part of the ICE group of photographers that are gonna be with us in the store and showing the work with ICE. And it's funny because I think that I started to see your work like almost from the beginning. I think is when I started to encounter your work, and I've seen that how you changed your work to being more and more mature. But from the beginning, it has been always like a revelation, like a very different and very fresh and very unique kind of eye and the way you work with the colors and the lights. I remember when you were working with yourself, with your own image, and you were multiplying your image in different places. And then you started to play also with the colors in portraits and the way sometimes you put like a light, almost like a beam like on top of a person to emphasize specific areas of the photography. How do you see? How was your progression, or can you tell me a bit about your work in general, just as a bird's view? You know how it evolved with the time.
First of all, thank you for the invitation, for this long time friendship, and well, the evolution. I think it's becoming somehow an experimentation, and always looking in the medium of photography as a medium for exploration about some ideas and ancient and cycles in life. I think it changes the way you look for, and that's the way you I remember that you saw these first bodies of work that I was experimenting with myself and with some friends, and always looking for the light and very staged images. And I think the key, or in somehow the of my work, it's about the a reflection about the individual inserted in a contemporary society, and how it's gonna evolution that in my work. I think it's like in somehow it's the main theme that has changed in time. I've been doing photography maybe since 18 years old, and always looking for new bodies of work, new changes, and that's how I think it's how it changed for the time.
Yeah, because I noticed that, for instance, in the there was I found like very intriguing series that you developed along all of these years, on which you changed all that, like, even almost like a different style of photography, because you have the first ones that were, as you said, very staged, very produced in terms of the colors, the lights, and even the attitude of the models, and you know, very theatrical, no, almost like a representation of something. I remember that you were, when you were younger, you were telling me about the photos of Philip Lorca. I remember that you were telling me that it was a big influence for you.
A project called Stress.
Uh-huh.
At that time, I was experimenting a lot with a computer and lighting.
And everything was as we said at this, it was very prepared. And then you have other series that for me were like a very interesting to find, like the one that it was for, like the Elephant Cemetery, you know, Elephant's Graveyard, which is almost like a direct photography, you know, of landscapes and a very, very like kind of devastated landscapes with some constructions and urban elements almost in decay in most of the times. How did you plan it, or what, how was the connection between that one and, or what, how do you see that that series?
I think it has the computer. It's the main principal connection between both works, or most of my work. And in that case, for Elephant Cemetery, I was navigating a lot in internet, and I was making some photographs about the new Mexican territory, and I was trying to find and make me a memory about places that I never been, and a memory from a artificial screen life. So I was driving through Google Maps, and I took these pictures, and then I cut it and do like a edit about 60 images from 1 year taking pictures from different parts of Mexico.
It reminded me some of the almost like landscape photography, or some of the artists that live like in the north of Mexico, that that they show like these places that are, they're like almost like no man's land, no, with very deserted and very lonely and dusty.
Yes, and also it's like trying to expand the photography and using the cameras of the webcams and cameras of Google Maps, and using this kind of character, the pixel, and this loss of information, how it connects now, and how we see the world in a JPEG quality.
And you mentioned that it's like that you were trying to develop a memory of a place that you've never been.
I never been to those places, and I just taking photographs from a robot, so from this Google Maps car, and I edit and put this. That's together.
Because it reminds me of your other project that is called Dobernard, is the other one?
Dobernard. Yes, it's about the family, about the past. Good past, and making a fiction about my own family. And I use my archive from my family, and also use some actors and people. And I try to make a fiction about my own family where it's a joke in somehow, because I think the album family, it's a fake, that you always take pictures in a stage time that when people are happy and having dinner, and it's like, hey, take a picture, and the whole family stand for that picture. So I try, when my daughter born, I try to make this kind of family album. And it's an album that it has a family that it's Catholic and hunter at the same time. So it's like a mystery narrative, and looking through the past also.
No, and it does a trick, because you feel that you're watching like very authentic photographies, but you always have this idea: is this true or not? No, is this the reality or not? And I think it's very well done. I think it's interesting. And then we arrive to this, to your latest series, or the one that I think is the latest. It's called Dystopia, and that had like a very good reception in different places, no, in different spaces and galleries, and it has been traveling, no, I understand, and received some awards. Tell me a bit about Dystopia. How did you start that? And because it's like a big project, no?
It's a project, it's the biggest one that I made. It's I traveled through 3 years to Latin America, and I was with a grant from Mexico, and it's a grant from Artist Creators, and that gave me the opportunity to make this kind of travels. And I was in different countries, and I try to find this kind of in the future, how it's gonna be the future in 30, 50 years, and also focus on a fluid Latin America, full of colors, and how it perceives in the future Latin America, and how it's connected with the colors and traditions. And it has a lot of posthumanism and posthumanism theory and technology and lonely landscapes, and always try to traveling in different deserts from Peru, Argentina, Chile, Mexico, Colombia, in the jungle, and different places. So for me, it's a very introspective trip through these 3 years of my life.
And where did you show it? Because it I know that it traveled, no? It went to different places with the exhibition itself? Or where did you show the exhibition?
I started to show the work 2 years ago, and it will very good open. I exhibit this work in Ukraine for the whole country in a collective exhibition, and Photo Kyiv also. And I have an individual show in Montevideo, in Centro Fotográfico de Montevideo. It has opened the last year, and again, it's traveling through Uruguay to Cablin space in Uruguay. And then I was also show in a collective in Mexico, and this year is gonna show a special video in Arles, in France. But now with the COVID, it's suspended. But for me, it's very important also this project because it's shown in technologies, magazines, and researchers, and it's not just photography medium somehow. So for me, it's very important this kind of approaches.
It's more like a research project, no?
Yes, it's a research, but it's also a fiction because nobody can know how it's going to be the future. Uh-huh. But I try to make this point of view.
Mm-hmm. And who designed the clothing? Eh? Because you have some of the photos are people like dressed and like in this almost like a COVID-19 suits, no? And kind of like the COVID-19 fashion avant la lettre, no? Before it was like that. So who did the design? You did the design, or
I always work by myself. So yes, I find the clothes, and I in Mercado de Pulgas, in the flea markets in South America or Mexico, I bought some things, and I stitch together, and I use it in the whole travel, in different travel. Mm-hmm. I find some pieces and I use it. So yeah.
And this idea of this kind of like eminences or mounts or even islands, that there are several images that you paint those and you transform the color of the landscape to give like a special. How did you integrate those into what was your idea behind all of that?
Yeah, for me the color is very important because it has a reflection about the contradictory about the technology in the future. So that's why I use a lot of pink and blue, these opposite colors. And I want to make the landscape like a new landscape, like you don't know where is it or in which time is it in time, and you don't know where is the place in somehow. So that's why I want to making another approach about the landscape, because I don't want to just be in Atacama and desert and took pictures like everyone. That is a beautiful, one of the most important places I've never been, and I want to make another approach.
And you also work on video, no? Because you did some. I know that you work on video, and you give a very similar treatment to the video. I mean, you work a lot on the colors and the lights and all that. What's your experience working with moving images? In comparison to what you do with still images, how do you see that?
Well, I think that the image is very expanded now, that you need to work with in my case, with movement and with still images, and approaching with stop motion and video, it's very different the way you look, and you find the sound also, and the sound is very important in my case, to putting in a in the galleries or the museum or in the space, this photo installation with lights and with sound also, it's more like to have a bigger or a best perception there on the whole experience.
Yeah, it's like a full experience, no? When you arrive, you're experiencing the whole thing. And you've been working with a musician. You work with or how do you do like the score, the sound on the?
Well, the sound, I use it some sound that I have. And for example, in Montevideo, it's a very reto for me, because it's from a building, an architecture from Art Deco. So I want to make in these kind of places, very historical, very important, to make it in the future. So I work with a friend from Montevideo that works with light. So Juan use the light and put these kind of tubes. I make the distribution, but he also worked with me. So how we can put to make the whole experience better. So in that case, it's very nice to work.
Yeah, and because also the collaborations that you have are quite interesting as well. I mean, you have that collaboration, and for me, it was a very strange project, the one of the coca.
We made it in Bolivia. For me, Bolivia, it's the first time I've never been, and it's blown my mind, and it's 2 weeks working in that project about the coca and the meaning of this, like a sacred plant.
No, I think it's a very interesting culture in general, and I think the project, it's a project that is really intriguing, because it's not only like the ceremony of the coca, but also the way that the images are constructed, and you feel like you're playing like a Ouija, no, like the Ouija, no, you're playing a bit like the finding the letters and all that, which is also a very nice twist or like an angle, no, like a trick which works very nicely.
Yeah, we found this petals and animals for the market, and they nos prestaron the animals, because it's for the Pachamama traditions, but we make this kind of spiritual with the tradition, and make a mix and make a new kind of Ouija and things like very spiritual.
What's next, I mean, for you? I mean, and now everybody's in confinement, and now everybody's like in lockdown, but what are your plans for the future? What are you going to be doing next?
I don't know what's going on in the next, but I want to make a new project, and I'm reading and doing things, something that make me in the brain something new, and make something different from dystopia also. I want to make a new kind of project, but with these 4 months in the house make me a lot to see the world in another dimension, and how the behavior from all of us changes the fear, and with the panoptic, with a lot of things happening around. So
yeah.
So in the future, I think it's an era, a time that it's very complicated also.
Yes. So, yeah, very unique. Yeah, definitely. Fernando, thank you very much for the time, and we're very happy to have your images with us, and I hope we can see each other very soon, I mean, if here or in Mexico, or I don't know, in Bolivia, maybe in Cochabamba or something like that. Well, I really hope that you enjoy this conversation, and if you like this work and you want to know more, and if you want to acquire some of these pieces, we have special editions of any of the pieces of this artist at the Ice Photography Shop. This is the address, icestore.me, and if you have any questions, please feel free to contact us as exchange@iceamericas.org. And soon we're going to have also collaboration workshops, so
stay tuned and hope to see you soon.